Everyone, so today we will be starting our third chapter. I think we are able to hear me clearly. So third chapter, that is introduction to data structure and linked list, is there your third chapter? So that we will be studying. Any idea what is data structure? Yes, any idea what is data structure? Yes, any idea what is data structure? Why we use data structure? Anyone? What is data structure? Data means, you know, DBM is fully of study. Some small piece of this, some information, small piece of information, or some this, what is it? Some record is known as data. Then what is structure? Structure means arranging it so that your program can use efficiently. What will happen? Now you're writing small programs, but tomorrow you might be developing big programs, like your student, this BTLinks is there, yes or no? So if you, it is not developed efficiently, what will happen? You'll try to see the result and you will not get the result only. Always it will tell server busy, because your resources will be less, or program will be slow. Even WhatsApp, how you use WhatsApp? Yes. So what will happen in WhatsApp? You send, I'll send a message, immediately it goes. If it was not written efficiently, what would happen? Your pro, this, what is that? Your, this should not go only. Message would not go only. Okay. So we will see the third chapter. First, we'll see the syllabus copy. So your third chapter, after learning third chapter, see there they have told what is the outcome. Describe data structure and different types of linked list. So after you learn this chapter, you should be able to do this. Okay. That is, you should be able to describe the data structure as well as know the different kind of linked list. So this is your third chapter. Okay. This is your third chapter, introduction to data structure and linked list. Okay, 10 hours chapter, you will get 28 marks from here. So if you study this, 28 marks. So if three chapters also you study, you will pass in this subject. So let's see what are the contents of this third chapter. Chapter name is Introduction to Data Structure and Linked List. So you'll be studying about introduction to data structure. That is, well, what is data structure, its characteristics, types of data structure, and its operation. And a small part on linked list. Okay, so many data structures you will be studying in this chapter, this subject. One is linked list, then stack and queue, tree, sorting, searching, and application of data structure. So in this chapter, you will be studying only one data structure, that is linked list. Okay, so let's start. Hope PPT is visible to you. So we'll be starting with your third chapter. Okay, that is Introduction to Data Structure and Linked List, and session one in that. So today we'll be studying two things. One is, what is data structure, and characteristics of data structure. So let's see what it is. Okay. So let's see what is data first. What do you mean by data? Yes. You have studied many times, you use data. This, someone wants to tell something. This, what is that? Your friend's phone number, that is one data. Or maybe some, this, your register number, it is one data. Yes. So it is nothing but collection of raw facts. Okay. So example, quantities, they are telling characters or symbols. Okay. Then when this data will become information. Data are just some this raw facts, like your phone number or anything. So next, what is information then? So information is nothing but processed data. Okay. So if you have only data, it is not useful. For example, if I have only your marks, is that useful? No. only marks is not enough. What I have to do, I have to collect some information like how many have passed, how many have failed, how many have got FCD. That is nothing but information. See, they have given one example here. Can you read this? This is one example of data, just a collection of characteristics. It has no meaning. Whereas second one, information. My name is Krishna is there. So systematic arrangement of data is known as information. It will have some proper, if data has proper meaning, it is called information. Otherwise, just raw fact is not enough. Okay. And this data, to arrange it in a proper way so that the program can use efficiently, we use something called data structure. So let's see what is data structure. Data means raw fact. Okay. So if to make your program efficient and fast, we have to arrange the data properly. For example, see now, if you have a cupboard, okay, you might be having a cupboard. How you'll arrange your dresses? Yes, you might be arranging it in the different shelves, no? Home wear, yes, college wear, okay, or some other party wear, yes or no? If we all together, I'll just wrap and keep in cupboard, what will happen? Next time when I'm searching something, I have to throw all the things, find all the where it is kept. Yes or no? So if it is arranged properly, quickly you can take what you want from your cupboard and use it. So same way, if your data in data structure, if data is arranged properly, your program can use efficiently. So this is known as the way of organizing and storing the data in memory is known as data structure. So remember, what is data structure? It is a systematic way to organize the data, okay, to be used efficiently. You want to tell something? So examples, then which are the different data structure? One is arrays, okay? So what this arrays will do, how the arrays are arranged in a sequential manner, okay? So they have and also you have some data structures like int, float, characters. These all are built in. Okay. Array is derived. Okay. And also we have user defined also. Three types of data structure we have. One is built in, int, float, char. Then we have derived. Derived are which? Array, strings. Then we have user defined. In user defined, you have stack, queue, linked list, etc. Okay, so that you will be studying. Just remember, what is data structure? It is a systematic way to organize data so that it can be used efficiently. So next we'll see what are the characteristics of data structure. Okay, so what are the characteristics? First one is it depicts logical representation of data. That is how it is actually. Actually, you can see the data. Maybe some, if you consider your phone number, you can see the numbers. How it is actually stored? Maybe some number is there. How it is actually stored? In logical representation, in the form of bits. Yes or no? So if you have a data structure, it will help you to store it in the logical representation of data in computer memory. And it helps in logical relationship between various data elements, okay? And if data structure, since it is efficient way of arranging the data, okay? So it helps in efficient manipulation of stored data elements, and it also allows the program to process the data in an efficient way. So if you have, these are the four characteristics of data structure. That is, it helps in logical representation of data in a computer memory. It establishes logical relationship between data element, and if you use data structure in efficiently, you can store it, and also your program can use it efficiently. These are the four characteristics of data structure. So can you answer this now? So can you answer this? What is data structure? What is data? Can anyone answer? And what are the characteristics of data structure? Three things I have covered. So now, what is data structure? Can anyone tell? Telling? Yes. What is data structure? It is efficient way of arranging the data so that program can utilize it efficiently. Okay, that is data structure. Example, arrays, float, char, stacks, cubes. Then what is data? Yes, what is data?
Information.
Data is not information, it is a record. Just now we saw it. See, there is a difference. Data means collection of raw facts. Information means which has proper meaning. Don't get confused. Data is collection of raw facts. Okay, I gave you an example. Like your marks is data, but how many people have passed, distinction and all can be information. Okay. And what are the characteristics of data structure? Okay, these four are there. It represents what? Logical representation of data in computer memory. It helps in logical relationship, efficient manipulation of stored data, and program also can process the data in an efficient manner. These three we have studied. So we'll see one video on data structure, then I'll continue. So just you'll get an idea about data structure after seeing a video, then I'll continue. Okay. Okay, thank you. You can see the video. Okay, sir. You can see the video, right?
For day-to-day life, many applications such as browser, Google Maps, use some of the data structure concepts. So this video will give you a better understanding of why should you learn data structures. So let us learn how data structures play a major role in our day-to-day life. So we all must have used online ticket booking systems at least once. It might be for booking tickets for train, or maybe bus, or flights, or movies, or any other shows. If we want to book any seat, it is just a matter of clicking on a square. But have you ever wondered that this is a two-dimensional array, and this seat, which is in row 3 and column 4, is seat of 3, 4.
So see how seat booking app you have used, no? So what data structure they are using? They are using array. Two-dimensional array. So like this, you will see how where all the data structure is used in this video. Then I will continue with the data structure.
Is a real-life application of the model. Now let us understand a browser's working. So we are first going to a web page, www.google.com. Now we are visiting the website log2base2.com. Now there is a YouTube link. Now we click there and we go to that address. So whenever we visit a web page, see that URL is stored there. Now we can click on the back button and go to last visited web page. See, when we click here, we are back to log2base2.com.
You're getting this, how the stack works? See, first this user went to google.com, then log2base2.com, then some other page. Yes or no? Then when he was pressing back, he was coming to previous page. How it is possible? Because of a data structure called stack. Okay.
And from there, we can go back to www.google.com as well. We are familiar with these operations of a browser. And this is actually an application of stack, which follows the last and first out principle. That is, who came last will be gone out.
So this stack is a data structure which follows LIFO order. Okay. Can you see? Which google.com was opened first, then log2base, then something else. Then which back you were doing, which was deleted first, which was opened last. So it is called last in, first out.
So simply by clicking a back button, you can go to last visited website. So that is how a stack is useful in our daily life. And we all have stood in a queue at somewhere in our life.
So this is one more data structure we'll be studying, that is queue. Okay, so stack you will be studying, linked list you'll be studying, queue you'll be studying, arrays you have already studied. Okay, this let's see what is queue.
And who comes first in the queue will be shown first and can go on like this. That is first in, first out principle, which is exactly what a queue data structure means. Who comes first will be served first. But stack was last in, first out. Who came last will be served first. Now, can you think of any
activity? See, queue, how it is? First in, first out. Who came first will be first, served first. How was the stack? Which came last? Okay, that was served first. So last in, first out is stack. Queue is first in, first out.
Application for linked list. See, we all have music player in our phones and we'll have songs in it. Suppose you have four songs in your phone. After playing song one, song two will be played. Then song three will be played. And then song four will be played. Like that. It doesn't stop after playing.
See, this is third linked list. That is third data structure, that is your linked list. They are giving the example of song, how the song will be played, one after the other. Can you see here? Song 1, then song 2, song 3, song 4. Okay. So for that, we use the data structure called linked list.
One song. The next song will be played. So the songs are connected just the way notes are connected in a linked list. So this is an application of a simply linked list. The simply linked list, the nodes are connected in a simple way. So we can go to song 3 from song 2, but we cannot go in backwards. And in doubly linked list, the nodes are connected in both.
In singly linked list, okay, in linked list again different types are there, singly and doubly. In singly list, linked list means they showed you example. Song 1 to song 2, song 2 to song 3, song 3 to song 4 we can go. But you cannot go back. Whereas in doubly linked list, you can go back also and front also.
Both directions. So we can go either way. So we can play song 1, then song 2, then song 3. And from song 3, we can play song 4 as well as song 2. That is, we will have both previous and next buttons. So bidirectional navigation is possible. And after all the songs are played, the music player will stop playing. But sometimes we play a playlist in a repeat mode so that after the last song is completed, the first song will start playing.
See, one more thing, okay? That is third data structure in linked list is circular linked list, okay? That is, in singly linked list, what it was happening, only it was going forward. In doubly linked list, previous and front. In circular linked list, after last one, okay, after last, you can go back, again play the same. So this is known as circular linked list. That is, one has played, two has played, three has played, four has played. You can go back and forth, as well as after last is over, you will come to first and continue. This is known as circular linked list.
And it will play in the cyclic mode and will never stop. So that is a circular linked list. The last node is connected to the first node. That is, the last song is connected to the first song again, and it will repeat the playlist. So that is how linked lists are useful in our daily life. Now, everybody uses Google Map. And can you guess which data structure it uses? Google Map.
You have used Google Map, right? So let's see which data structure is used in Google Map. Many people, many times you will use Google Map, no? So for that also we have some data structure. So let's see.
Which is the graph data structure, but all the cities.
So they use graph for your third semester, fourth semester. You don't have graph data structure, but there is a subject in next semester, that is design and analysis of algorithm. There you will be studying about graphs. So for your map, we use graph data structure. So let's see how it works.
If we want to go from Tamil Nadu to Delhi, there might be many ways, but using some algorithms, we can select the shortest path, which saves a lot of time.
So maps you have used, right? What it will do? It will give the shortest path. How it will do? It will put all the cities in a graph and then use some algorithm to find the shortest path.
For example, this way it takes 1,000 kilometers. This one will take 1,500 kilometers. and this one will take 2000 kilometers. And the shortest path is 1000 kilometers. And we can proceed with this one. So that is how data structures play a major role in our day-to-day life. In the upcoming series, we will learn how to implement all the data structures.
So you got the idea which are the different data structure and how they're used in real life? Yes? Which all data structure we saw in the video? We saw arrays. Okay, we saw example how it is used in the real life for seat booking and all. Okay, next we saw this. What is that? Linked list. Okay, in that we saw singly linked list, doubly linked list, circular linked list. Then we saw stack queues. One more data structure is there, trees. That also you'll be studying this semester. Okay, so any doubts you have so far? Yes, any doubts you have? Okay, bye.